When you're young, it happens all the time. In gym class, on playgrounds, even on outdoor rinks. Tonight in Carolina, the stars have aligned, and these two men will choose their weapons. With so much talent on display, how will they decide?
Two is always better than one.
Can anyone else do this?
This is what makes Ovechkin special.
I want Olympic gold.
And Canada has once in a lifetime Olympic gold.
I actually want an Olympic gold and a Stanley Cup.
I want a Stanley Cup too.
They score! The Hawks win the Stanley Cup! The Hawks win the Stanley Cup!
I'm a Canadian Olympian and World Junior Champion.
The celebration begins. Canada is on top of the hockey world.
You gotta pick me.
You're not gonna split us up, are you?
Make the smart choice. Pick us.
Pick me.
Pick us.
You gotta pick Ovi.
The NHL All-Star Fantasy Draft is coming up.
Feel free to discuss. Let me know when you're ready.
Good. Announce it.
You do it. Do it.
All right, with our next pick, I'm gonna take my boy, the Norris Trophy winner, Duncan Keith.
He is indeed a Norris Trophy winner. What a season last year for Duncan Keith. He won everything. He won the Norris. He won the Stanley Cup. He won a gold medal with Team Canada. Wasn't chosen until 54th in the 2002 draft. He goes early in the first All-Star draft. Duncan, join your team. Let's check in quickly with Jonathan Toews. Yeah, stand up for me. I don't know, Conn Smythe winner, best forward in the Olympic Games. When Kaner started to say, my boy, did you start to stand up? And then he went, what?
I was halfway up the steps right here, too. I'm kind of shocked and disappointed right now.
What is the problem right now between you and Patrick Kane, who made a vow that he did not want to select you and wanted to play against you in this game?
Well, that's a tough decision for him. So, if it was in his best interest, I think he would have picked me with that one. But obviously, I can't blame Dunks. He's a great player. So,
dissension in the Chicago locker room. Thanks, Jonathan. I'm sure it won't be too long. It's time for pick number five and Team Stahl. This is the ninth pick as we begin round five, and it's back to Team Stahl as the strategy starts to become more and more important.
Then you think back to last year's Olympics with the Chicago Blackhawk defenseman Duncan Keith and the Nashville Predator defenseman Shea Weber. Those guys were the block upon which Canada was built and led them to a gold medal. So Team Lidstrom, thinking outside the box, they got some hockey savvy on that coaching staff.
There's some strategy in this, Keith.
Yeah, there seems to be. Patrick Kane doesn't seem to want Jonathan Toews that bad on this team. It's always been Kane and Toews. We'll have to see if those two are playing together.
No, I think that Patrick's just tired of Jonathan yelling at him on every line change.
That's a lot of fun. The excitement continues to build, James.
All right, thank you very much, guys. We're going to take a short break. Come back with round six and beyond at the first ever NHL All-Star Fantasy Draft, powered by Cisco.
Ernest put the Sabines on for sure.
He is having one heck of a year. 26 goals this season, on pace for 44, which would crush his career high of 32 goals for Daniel Briere. One goal and four assists in the 2007 All-Star game. Team Lidstrom, you have the 14th pick, the last pick of round number seven.
You want to go with Buff then?
Yeah.
Pick Buff?
Yeah.
Our next pick, from Atlanta, Dustin Byfuglien.
What a season Dustin Byfuglien is having. He told Patrick Kane, you better pick me. And With the help of Nick Lidstrom and Marty St. Louis, he ends up on his former teammate's team. Only player in the game traded from last year's team, Chicago to Atlanta, where they moved him from forward to defense. And boy, what a season Dustin Bufflin is having. 16 goals and an NHL-leading 3 overtime winners. John Tavares, the only other player with 3 OT winners in the National Hockey League. We go to round 8 and pick number 15, and we go back to Team Stahl.
Sharp?
Sure. You go ahead. Yeah, you go ahead. Yeah, you go. Oh.
We're going to take from the Chicago Blackhawks, Patrick Sharp.
Patrick Sharp gives a pat on the back to Jonathan Taves as the wait continues for Taves. Patrick Sharp scored a team-high 11 goals during Chicago's championship run and is leading the Hawks once again this season with 26, including 6 game winners, which is tied for the NHL lead. And yes, another connection for Eric Staal. He takes the Thunder Bay buddy. And as soon as Eric Staal was named captain, Patrick Sharp gave him a text and said, I voted for you to be captain. You better darn well pick me. Patrick Sharp ends up on Team Staal. Pick number 16 for Team Lidstrom.
All right, can't believe I'm going to do this, but I'll take Jonathan Taves from Chicago.
The wait is over for Jonathan Taves, who was third overall in 2006 and had to wait a lot longer this year. The 2010 Conn Smythe Trophy winner, the best forward at the 2010 Olympics, 100 career goals already, and one of the best face-off men in hockey, which should help in the All-Star game. Let's get Patrick Kane and Jonathan Taves over here for a second. Patrick, Jonathan, we're all about bringing people together. All right, now this went completely against your strategy. Did Marty and Nick finally get to you and say, look, we got to take Taves, he's been sitting there all day?
Yeah, it was between Taves and someone else, and I saw him sitting over here sweating, so I thought I'd take some pressure off him.
They gotta go.
So it sounds like pity, again, is the only reason he selected you.
No, I think he swallowed his pride big time on that one. So a smart pick, but, I won't disappoint.
Same question I asked Mark Staal. Is this good enough to get over it, or leaving you hanging there long enough, there'll still be some bitterness afterwards?
I don't know. I think that decision came from the other two guys. I don't think it's coming from this guy, that's for sure.
Kane's getting no credit as Jonathan Taves joins Nick Lidstrom's team. We are at round number 9 and pick number 17 overall. So it starts to get really interesting. We go back to Eric Staal. Patrick Sharp, could you come down and join me? Jonathan Taves, Marc-Andre Fleury, and Jonas Hiller. So the goaltenders are now finished. Remember, they have to have all their defense finished by the 15th round. And so the last round will involve all forwards. Time now for the Cisco Fantasy Insider. You know, you're used to having Bob McKenzie and Darren Dreger as our insiders, but we wanted somebody really, really on the inside, so we have Patrick Sharp. First of all, was it actually tough sitting down there waiting before you were selected?
It was. It was a little nerve-wracking. I was surprised to go so high, so I got to thank the captains for taking me, but a little more relaxed now, that's for sure.
Okay, you're the insider. How much lobbying has been going on over the past few weeks, over the past few hours, and right up till now, via text, phone calls, whatever it may be?
Well, I've done some research, and I got a little more respect for these guys over there. They get more information than I do, but the only lobbying I know that was going on was probably me with Patrick Kane and Eric Staal, so I guess I'm the worst one.
Wait a second, so you were lobbying both sides the whole way? That's somewhat pathetic, but smart, I suppose. Were you happy to end up with Team Staal?
Happy to go with Team Staal. Proud to be from Thunder Bay, Ontario, and we got a couple guys on the team, the two Staal brothers and myself. But I'm probably most excited about going one pick higher than Jonathan Taves.
Oh, the Chicago rivalries continue. Do your best, Pierre McGuire, Bob McKenzie, Keith Jones, Darren Dreger. Analyze the team so far from what you've seen. I know you're going to be a little biased towards Team Staal, but do you like your team?
I like it a lot. It seems to have a lot of offense on it. We look to be like a run-and-gun team, some offensive defensemen, and they got a tough job, those guys. I think I'd rather be sitting in the crowd getting drafted than putting a team together, but they're doing a great job.
Thank you very much. Good job. He does a radio show in Chicago, and we have a spot reserved for him on the panel when he retires in 10 years or so. Patrick Sharp is our insider, powered by Cisco.
You fought Taves, who's over on Team Lidstrom. You fought Corey Perry, who's just sitting a couple spots down from you. He hasn't been picked either. And you picked Rick, and you fought Rick Nash, I believe, who's over on Team Stahl. So there won't be a fight in the All-Star game, will there?
Not if we all get on the same team with Nasher up there. I've offered to all buy him a free beer in the back, but they've all declined for some reason. So it's all in good fun. We'll have a good time out there, and you know, hopefully we can find some skill to display.
All right, David Backus. Let's hope the wait is not too long for David Backus. Right back to pick number 28 as we finish round number 14. Patrick Kane, Marty St. Louis, and Nick Lidstrom.
All right, our next pick. Played with him in Chicago. He was awesome. Marty Havlat.
Quietly having another very strong season in Minnesota. He's on pace for 73 points, would be the second highest in Marty Havlat's career. Was the 26th overall pick in 1999. This is his second All-Star game. All right, as Marty joins Team Lidstrom, we go right back to Eric Stahl.
Let me take you a little bit deeper in terms of what Lidstrom's done with his team. Stamkos and St. Louis ripping it up right now in Tampa. Duncan Keith, Shea Weber, not only with Team Canada, but also played together with the Kelowna Rockets in the Western Hockey League. Dustin Byfuglien, Jonathan Toews, Patrick Kane. Think about those guys.
Right.
You think that Nashville wants to think about them? You think Vancouver wants to think about them? You think San Jose wants to think about them? You think Philly wants to think about them? And those guys on Team Stahl, I don't think they're going to want to think about them either tomorrow.
Well, that's fine.
Or Sunday.
It took Patrick Kane and Team Lidstrom a little longer than most expected, Keith, to take Jonathan Toews.
Yeah, the Conn Smythe winner didn't go as quickly as you would think he would. Chicago Blackhawks had a few other guys taken before him, and then Dustin Byfuglien, of course, part of that team as well, was taken. Danny Briere, who played against the Blackhawks in the finals, was taken. And then finally, Jonathan Toews was taken after Patrick Sharp went. A little too late, but he's happy, and anyway, he's on a good team.
And all six of the players who were involved in the draft tonight were also involved in the Stanley Cup final.
Much media is the last pick in the game.
Oh, we're going to make him sweat. We're going to make him sweat it out. One guy I want to see sweat is Tazer.
We're going to take from the Chicago Blackhawks, Patrick Sharp.
Oh, attaboy.
This is nine. We have to pick a goalie.
Did you actually do much strategizing? Did you sit with your alternate captains before and say, okay, we want this guy, we want this guy, or did you just sort of wing it when you got out here?
We talked a little bit, you know, who's going to be the one, two picks, but then you're kind of just going down the line, and you can't go wrong with any of the players that you're picking, and just making sure you get all the goalies in before the 11th round and get all the D in as well. So before that, otherwise, you're just trying to get the players.
We all go through pools and fantasy drafts on our own, and there's always that guy you're about to pick, and then the other guy takes him. Was there one guy that got away that you really wanted on the team?
Yeah, there was a couple times where we were leaning towards someone and they had taken him right before us. But
give me a name. Come on. One guy you really wanted.
You know what? Taves. Jonathan Taves. Right. I mean, he was sitting there for a little while, but he was one of the guys.
Well, you had lots of chances to take him, so it's only your own fault. Listen, congratulations. Thanks for being such good sports. Nick Lidstrom, captain of Nick Lidstrom, and Eric Stahl. And here are their pick forms that they were filling out as they went along. They're probably headed to the Hockey Hall of Fame. We'll be back to wrap things up right after this. Everybody stand up, please, in their seats. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2011 All-Stars, Team Stahl and Team Lidstrom. You'll watch them on Sunday.